Good afternoon, class. Today I will be teaching about the topic Down syndrome. Okay, so this topic is taken from the subject genetics, and this is for BSc second year. So definition: Down syndrome (DS) is also called as trisomy 21. This is Down syndrome. So dusra naam kya hai? Trisomy 21. So it is a genetic condition that causes delay in physical and intellectual development. So children born with Down syndrome, okay, they will have improper physical structures, okay, where you know, they will have some facial deformity, or they will have some improper physical development, and also their intellectual, their thinking, okay, their thinking process, their abstract, their insight, okay, so they will have some delay in the development. So such children born with Down syndrome, okay, so they will have delay in physical and intellectual development. There is an extra genetic material from chromosome 21. So individuals with Down syndrome, they will have 47 chromosomes in total instead of usual 46. So we know that in a normal person, how many chromosomes are there? Total number of chromosomes, there are 46. Okay? And how many pairs of chromosomes are there? So there are 23 pairs of chromosomes. Okay, but in Down syndrome mein kya hota hai ki there is, you know, there is an extra genetic material in the number of chromosome 21. Okay, in the number 21 of the chromosome, there is an extra genetic material. So because of that extra genetic material, okay, so the total number of chromosome now will be 47, okay, plus 1. It is not 46, but it is 47 chromosomes. So remember this, that Down syndrome children will have 47 chromosomes, and there is an extra genetic material where in chromosome number 21. That is why we call it as trisomy 21. Okay? So let us see with the etiology and pathophysiology. Down syndrome is usually caused by an error in cell division, which is called non-dysfunction. So this is a reason, okay, this is the etiology, or this is the cause why there is an extra genetic material. Is this because there is an error, or there is some changes in the cell division? That is, this is called non-disjunction. Okay, so let us see what happens in the cell division. Okay, so during meiosis, one pair of chromosome, it does not divide. Okay, and the whole pair, it goes into the daughter cell. So what happens is that one pair of chromosome, it does not divide. It stays as it is, and it goes, and that whole pair is going into the daughter cell. In the resulting cells, one will have 24 chromosomes and the other will have 22 chromosomes. Okay, so if a sperm or an egg with an abnormal chromosome, it merges with a normal person. Okay, so like there is a normal person, okay, and there is a person with abnormal chromosome. Okay, so what happens is if they mate, okay, so the resulting fertilized egg now will have abnormal number of chromosomes. Okay, why? Because of that one pair. Okay, it is not dividing. Okay, it is not dividing, and it is going directly into the daughter cell. So because of that only, there will be some changes. Okay, and the change is that one will have 24 chromosomes and the other will have 22 chromosomes. So there are changes, right? So in trisomy, one cell has 21st chromosome instead of one. So the resulting fertilized egg has 3 21st chromosomes. Okay, so that is why in number 21 chromosomes, there will be how many, you know, you can see here in the number 21. Okay, so everyone has pairs, right? We know that there are pair of chromosomes. But in number 21, there are how many? There are 3. Okay, instead of 2, there are 3. Why? Because this pair, it does not divide. Okay, there is no division, and it goes directly into the daughter cell. So that is the reason why, you know, the child will have three chromosomes, okay, in this 21 number. Okay, so that is the main reason. I hope this is clear. Okay, so let me just repeat that in trisomy 21, one cell has 221st chromosome instead of one. So the resulting fertilized egg will have 3 in 21 chromosomes. Okay, so there will be 3 in 21 number of chromosomes. So there are many types of Down syndrome. So there are 3 types of Down syndrome. Let us see first. Number one is trisomy 21. 95% of the chances, 95% of the babies are born with this type, trisomy 21. Here the extra 21 chromosome, 3 instead of the usual 2. So usually how many pairs of chromosomes are there? There are basically 23 pairs. And in one pair, how many genetic material? There are 2 chromatids, right? So instead of 2, there are 3 now. Okay. So this extra 21 chromosome, 3 instead of 2, it will produce a complement of 47 chromosomes. Now there will be no more total number of chromosome 46, that is a normal, but it will have how many number of chromosome? 47 chromosomes. So this is trisomy 21. Next is translocation. This 3-4% of the babies will be born with this type of Down syndrome. A segment of 21 chromosome is found attached to other pairs of chromosomes. So instead, what happens is that translocation means changing of location or changing of position. So what happens is a segment of the 21 chromosome. Okay, now it will be found attached to the other pairs of chromosomes. So what happens is in the new pair of chromosome, now there will be 3 chromatids instead of 2. Okay, so this is translocation. Next is the mosaicism. Okay, 1-2% of the babies will be born with mosaicism Down syndrome, but the most common is trisomy 21. So in mosaicism, what happens is there is non-disjunction occurs at a later stage of cell division. Okay, so in the final stages of cell division, there will be this non-disjunction, which is the error in the cell division. Therefore, some cells will have the normal complement of 46 chromosomes, and the other cells will have 47 chromosomes with an extra 21 chromosomes. So these are some of the types of Down syndrome. Okay, so I hope this is clear. Next, coming to the risk factors. Who are the risk factors for having babies born with Down syndrome? So women who are 35 years or older, okay, they are at a higher risk of delivering babies with Down syndrome. Okay, so 35 years, the ratio is 1 by 400 live births. Okay, and if the pregnant mother is more than 40 years, then 1 by 110 live births. Then according to the CDC, the younger mothers less than 35 years who smoke, okay, the pregnant mothers below 35 years of age, if they are smoking or they are using any other contraceptive or they have a meiotic 2 error, then they are at a higher risk for developing for producing Down syndrome babies. Despite many years of research, advanced maternal age has been the only one factor that is well established with Down syndrome. So the main point here is that old age, okay, or advanced age of pregnant mothers, that is above 35 years of age. Now coming to the clinical manifestations of Down syndrome. Okay, so babies, they will have microcephaly, they will have a flat face with upward slant to the eye, short and wide neck, small low set ears, the nose will have a flat nasal bridge and a protruding. Okay, so the ears will be like this. Okay, their eyes are slanting, the nasal bridge is flat, okay, and their tongue will be protruding. Then we will have tiny spots, tiny white spots on the iris of the eye. That is called the brush field spot. Okay, on the iris of the eye, okay, there will be some tiny white spots. Next, we will have short, broad hands and feet with a single crease on the palm of their hand. So, they will have short and broad legs. Okay, even their hands also will be. Okay, they will be short. Okay, they will be short. Even their legs also will be short. And what happens in the palm? Okay, so this is a normal creases lines. Okay, creases are lines. So in a normal child, they will have lines. Okay, but in Down syndrome babies, what happens is, there will be a single line. You can see here, this is a single line. Okay, and in normal babies, they will have many lines. Okay. Next, babies, they will have small pinky fingers. Okay, small the small finger. Okay, the last fingers, small pinky fingers that sometimes curve towards the thumb. Then excessive space will be there between the large toe and the second toe, and there will be muscle hypotonia. Means there will be some, muscle contraction will be less. Okay, so this is about, these are the signs and symptoms. Okay, you can see the distance between the first toe and the big toe and the second toe. Okay, so there is a distance or there is a big space in between. Babies will have muscle hypotonia, means that their muscles will be inactive. Then there will be tiny spots on the iris. You can see these white tiny spots. Okay, this is called brush field spots. Then their small finger, you see the small finger, okay? We call it as a pinky finger. This is curved, not straight, but it is curved towards the thumb. And they will have short and broad legs and hands. Okay, and they will have a single line or single crease in their palm. So these are some of the signs and symptoms of Down syndrome. Now coming to the complications, okay? So we know that babies born with Down syndrome, they will have delayed physical and mental development. Okay, so 95% of individuals born with Down syndrome will have mild to moderate mental retardation. Okay, so first let us see is the mild and moderate mental retardation. So babies will have, like children will have delayed language. Okay, they will not, it will take time for them to understand the language, social development and motor development. Next, growth retardation. Okay, they will, their growth also will be, their growth hormones also will be very less. Okay, so that is why their height also will not increase. Next, congenital heart disease, 50%. Okay, they will have atrial or ventricular septal defect. Then, the respiratory infections like pneumonia and vision problems like cataract. These are some of the complications. Then babies, the children will also have hearing loss more than 60%. Then gastrointestinal blockage or gastrointestinal problems like esophageal atresia, duodenal atresia or celiac disease. Next, they will have thyroid dysfunction. Okay, their thyroid hormones also will be, there will be some defect in the thyroid hormones, sleep apnea, say 50% to 75%, and there will be an increased risk for dementia and higher risk for acute lymphocytic leukemia. Okay, so they are also at high risk for developing this type of leukemia. So these are some of the complications of Down syndrome. Next, a diagnostic test. Okay, so diagnostic tests are mostly done in on the pregnant mother, okay, during the pregnancy. So we know that first is the chorionic villus sampling. Okay, we know what is CVS. Okay, that is a sample of the placenta which is taken through the cervix or through a needle which is inserted into the abdomen. This test is performed between 8 to 12 weeks. Okay, then the second test is amniocentesis, where we take a small amount of amniotic fluid, okay, and we send it for checking the chromosomal errors or chromosomal abnormalities. This test is performed 12 to 20 weeks of pregnancy. Then there is also percutaneous umbilical blood sampling, that is taking blood from the umbilical cord of the baby. So it uses a needle to take a sample of blood from the umbilical cord, and this usually done after 20 weeks, okay, of pregnancy. After the baby is born, if Down syndrome is suspected, then a karyotype test, that is a blood or a tissue sample stained to show chromosomes grouped by size, number and shape, can be performed to confirm the diagnosis. So after the baby is born, you will perform a karyotype testing. Okay, in this karyotype testing, what do we do? We will check for the group of chromosomes. Okay, we will check for the number 21 chromosome, then we will check for the size, we will check for the numbers, and we will check for the shape. Okay, so that it will confirm the diagnosis of Down syndrome. Now, treatment. Down syndrome is not a condition that can be cured. Okay, treatment is directed at addressing the individual concern of a particular individual. Timely surgeries for cardiac and GI abnormalities are necessary to prevent any serious complications. So we know that one of the complications is heart defects, right? Cardiovascular defects and also the gastrointestinal abnormalities. So we can perform surgeries to correct these defects. Because the risk of vision problems, hearing loss and infection is increased, screening and treatment of such infections is necessary. Okay? So because there are chances that they will have cataract, so eye screening is very compulsory, hearing tests should be done, and we have to check for infection. So this is the treatment for Down syndrome. Now, nursing management. Nurse should obtain a history of mother's pregnancy, okay, birth history and genetic testing. So during when the mother is pregnant, then the diagnostic test should be performed. We should check the history of the mother. We should check the history of the family members also. Okay, then we observe the physical characteristics. Okay, check for the signs and symptoms of Down syndrome. Okay, we will assess the or monitor the respiratory function due to poor muscle tone. Check the heart sound for the presence of any murmur. Then check the infant's ability to eat because of the protruding tongue and the mouth breathing. Bowel functioning to be checked. In older child, assess the height and weight because there can be chances for growth retardation. Then check the mental development or cognitive development. Thinking, okay? Thinking, abstract, all these should be checked. Next, skin integrity should be checked. Should check for dry skin, rough skin, or crackling skin, and prevent any infection. Then we should monitor the family's knowledge about Down syndrome. How are they supporting and how are they coping with the disease condition? Next, observe interaction and bonding between the mother and the infant, and parental feelings about having a child with Down syndrome. So genetic counseling should be given out. Okay, so during the pregnancy, genetic counseling is very important, and we have to educate the parents about the Down syndrome. Okay, what is it all about, and how to cope up with the babies of Down syndrome. So we have come to the end of the topic for today, that is about Down syndrome. Okay, so I hope this is clear. Thank you, class.